Here's how a typical convolutional neural network architecture would look like. So this involves multiple convolution layers, as you can observe here. The input layer comprises of these different three-dimensional images, and there are 1,000 such samples or images in the example that's provided here. The convolution layer 1 basically carries out this convolution operation by making use of all these kernels. So these are 3D kernels. There are 32 such 3D kernels with which you'll carry out this convolutional operation so as to produce these output feature maps. You also can have an additional batch norm layer right after producing these output raw values. So this output raw values can be inputted for your batch normalization, basically to speed up the overall model training process, and it also brings some model stability. So the output of batch norm can also be fed as an input to your activation function so that you bring in some additional non-linearity to it. So you are learning some hierarchical features of your input data. And later you also can have an additional pooling layer. There exists a pooling layer in between different convolution layers, as you can observe, but we have not represented in the diagram as such. This conv layer 2 performs similar operations as we have discussed earlier. And this output feature map is being fed as an input to your fully connected dense layer. So this fully connected dense layer considers one-dimensional tensor for every given sample. And finally, we have an output layer. Depending on the problem that you are trying to solve, you have a different activation function. For example, if you are solving a binary class classification problem, you'll have a sigmoid activation. If you are looking at multi-class problem, then you'll have a softmax activation. And thereby you observe this class label here. So there is a class label associated with every single sample that's being represented in your input data. And there can also exist a global max pooling layer right before your fully connected dense layer as well. So this completes the whole CNN architecture.